very aware that we've only had male guests and we're trying very hard to balance it out. The reality, unfortunately, is that this is not a balanced event. There are far, far more men than there are women here.
I'm absolutely shattered. Absolutely shattered. Day 3. This is halfway, Jordan, halfway. There's a lot going on while we're here at Cannes, and it's good to be sort of on the ground as those stories are hitting. A lot of them are hitting the headlines on the drum main page as soon as we wake up, so to be there and react with the actual industry is incredible. But at the moment, the more pressing matter over the industry, me getting a cappuccino and possibly an orange juice is what's needed, definitely.
This is a man I'm very impressed.
Wow.
Is alive.
Whose idea was it to do a podcast at this time in the morning? It's ridiculous.
Go, and you're live.
Welcome to the Martinez back on Cannes Beach. James Kirkham from Copper 90. Let's talk women's football.
This is the first women's football tournament where it's not referred to as a women's football tournament.
Yeah, it's nice.
It's a football tournament.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's men or women is very much a secondary thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys are leading that charge, certainly pushing that really hard. Because, I mean, a year ago, 2 years ago, people were pushing it that way, but it felt a lot further away from today than we are now. It seems to have really sped up in the last 9 months.
I agree. I think it has. I think the idea that a little girl is going to be inspired for the very first time by someone like Nikita Paris, for example, and be able to consume it and be able to dive into it, that's a really good and important thing. And it isn't finished. There's still a long way to go, but there's a beautiful momentum and it's only going to continue.
How are you boys feeling about going live?
Yeah, looking forward to it. Not done LinkedIn live yet, because obviously hardly anyone's got access to it. So yeah, and you know what? It'd be nice to actually like get involved in some movies, like some stimulating conversation, because at the minute we're all rutting.
We've got the fantastic boys on the tools. Lee Wilcox, CEO, Adam Barry, creative director, huge Facebook page in the construction industry. Not a traditional place for Cannes Festival of Creativity.
No.
But here they are, all the way from Tamworth
no
in
clients,
the UK.
Yeah.
What I like about your business is how niche your offering is. You know, we're big believers in niche content to niche audiences at scale, right? So how do you continue to be niche and grow?
We're out.
Well done.
Really wow.
Well done.
Thanks, boys.
Yeah, thanks, boys.
That was really good. Two very different sessions, I suppose. James and Jack at the beginning, all around women's football. James is a brilliant speaker, head of Copper 90. I saw him on stage at Google Beach last year, actually, the first time I saw him talk, and he's a rock star.
Great.
All good. Live stream stayed up, so that's great.
Audio all good.
Yeah.
How comes we didn't see you too much yesterday?
I ended up doing a pricing model for about 6 p.m. till 9 p.m. last night. So I had my fallow day yesterday of no drinking, Glastonbury-esque, and now I'm back on it today.
We're setting up the drone, going to do a little flight. Such a beautiful place.
Should we count it down like a rocket launch?
We'll take it down.
Okay.
Jordan, did you get told off?
Yeah, I got told off.
Beautiful.
So we're here down at the front. Harry and the guys are currently having lunch. Here with Frankie, account director at Getty Images.
Hello.
So what are Getty Images doing here at Cannes?
So that's twofold. So the first thing is we sponsor the Young Lions competition every year. We're planting the seed about using Getty as a media and content provider. And then we have partnered with Dove for the hashtag Show Us campaign.
Uh-huh.
So there's lots of like Getty and Dove branding around the festival. It's a really sort of important campaign. It's timely. So yeah, we're doing a lot.
Has everything gone smoothly for you so far in terms of, are you able to get up in the morning? Are you feeling fresh today, day 3?
I haven't had a drink yet, so
well,
I could be better.
There we go.
It's been a really, really enjoyable day. We've had people drop in and out. Gave out some of these beautiful goat chilies bottles. So we're seeing those walking around Cannes now, people filling them up with either water to keep themselves hydrated or rosé to keep themselves on brand. I'm very, very privileged to be working in an industry which allows us to meet awesome people and do amazing things and call it work. Like, that's an amazing, amazing thing to be able to do. Overall, very, very happy with the trip. You've enjoyed it?
Yeah, I have, mate.
I told you, when I called you, I know, and said you're going to come to Cannes, it's going to be great. You go, oh, I'm not so sure.
It was worth it.
Tomorrow should be really good as well, podcast. We've got Jazz, who's talking about World Refugee Day. We've got the LinkedIn guys, Global Head of Product at LinkedIn, coming to talk to us about video, coming to talk to us about live streaming on LinkedIn. Flown over from San Francisco. Really, really excited to talk to him. I think that's going to be really insightful. His name's Sadeep, so look out for him on the LinkedIn Live. See what LinkedIn are planning, see what their product roadmap is, see what they're trying to do with video.
It's been another good day in Cannes. Got some brilliant guests on tomorrow and some women on tomorrow, which is great. We're very aware that we've only had male guests and we're trying very hard to balance it out. The reality, unfortunately, is that this is not a balanced event. There are far, far more men than there are women here. And so we are trying to even that up. There are some unbelievable female leaders that we have been talking to and who have been lined up to be on the podcast, and then for one reason or another just haven't quite got on. But tomorrow we really do have a bumper show.
We've just had a very nice girl come in and she's dropped me off possibly the most creative CV I've ever seen. Hello, my name is Rebecca Thomas and I want to work with you. I love that she's given us a suggested timeline of when we should hire her as well. Brilliant. Girl's got balls. I love it.
Do you want to hear an interesting fact about me?
Go on.
I've never written a CV.
You've never?
No.
She's got two first names. Never trust anyone with two first names.
Michael Oliver would now sit down. So, where are we headed to today?
We are going to a marketing networking event. Try to connect with new people, create some more good relationships, and it'll be fun.
Yeah, we'll keep you posted.
Yeah, just keep walking.
More members of the team are going out and not only meeting people, but also finding out more about other marketing channels. It's a key thing that a lot of the team say in their kind of one-on-one reviews is, how can I keep progressing, you know, within their role, within their kind of existing knowledge cycle? And one of the answers is often find out more about programmatic, paid social, so that when you're speaking to a client, you can more confidently tell them why we are a preferable option or how we can complement their wider strategy.
Thanks, Nick.
Thanks, Dan.